I have a needle phobia, which has been splendid through having kids. When I was a kid, I would watch my uncle take his blood sugars. And I always thought, I'm going to end up diabetic. I know it. And of course, cancer wasn't really on my radar. And so I've done exposure therapy and through a ton of work, I'm still not great, but I still have panic attacks on the regular around it. But oftentimes when I'm sitting there about to get blood work done, the nurse says, just breathe. And to me, I thought, well, what am I going to do? Hold my breath? Of course, I'm just going to breathe. To me, it meant nothing. And then I started learning a little bit about meditation. I started learning a little bit about belly breaths. I was actually, because my back isn't great, I was getting a massage. And my massage therapist said, breathe through your belly. And so I went through my chest. And I said, well, I can't. Like, I'm just built. I can't do it. And she said, no, everybody can breathe through your belly. And I went, and I couldn't do it. And I thought, oh my gosh, there's something like innately wrong with me. I can't breathe through my belly. And so she said, it takes practice. And I thought, well, no, you should just be able, you know, I'm one of those people. So I would go home and I go, I'm still not doing it. And finally learned how to calm down and how to breathe through your belly. So in doing that, when I would hear a nurse say, just breathe, in those moments for me of high anxiety, it is very difficult for anybody, but when I'm about to get a needle, to hear just breathe, it means nothing to me. It's the same as keep blinking. Like, of course I'm gonna do that. But through belly breathing, I've learned that taking that big in your belly does, there's something, you can feel it in your chest. It's just the relaxing aspect of it. And it helps with meditation. It helps with my sanity. And how much it actually translates into well-being, which I had no concept of when people would say, well, just breathe, and then just breathe through your belly. I did not understand, but it was through a lot of work that sometimes now I have pretty wicked insomnia. And sometimes I was recently told actually by my exposure therapist, I shouldn't be quoted on this, but it is impossible to take deep breaths while being grateful for something and still experiencing, and then whatever it is. So it's nausea, anxiety, whatever it is. So sometimes it doesn't matter if I'm about to get a needle or if I'm trying to sleep up in bed, I will just take deep breaths and keep listing things that I'm grateful for. And sometimes it works for 2 seconds and it goes away and then I'm back into a panic attack or whatever it is. But those 2 seconds, oh, I just try to hold on to them. And then I'm encouraged to try it again. So just breathe actually does translate into quite a powerful message. I just think it's lost sometimes in the language almost, or in the assumption that you know how to just breathe through your belly.